What I hoped to achieve out of bringing them here was being able to compare their lives with them and realising that you can be still happy and not have a lot of things. It's not about winning a trophy. It's about what you can experience in life and knowing other people that are out there the same as you in age, but not the same as you in materialistic things. Personally, and I was adopted, so you can mirror the experiences. What if I was born in a country like this? I wouldn't be adopted, because you can't be adopted out of these orphanages. Hello, I'm Peter.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm Go Hing.
Sorry?
My name Go Hing.
Go Hing.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for having us here today. We look forward to sharing some time with all the little kids here. Hello.
Yeah.
Oh. Hello.
And over here is their lockers.
There's a child, a little kid.
Yeah. Sleeping. This one here, I think he's blind. Hello.
Hello.
See the camera? Wave to the camera. I think he's a little bit blind. Poor little thing.
And I was pleasantly surprised when I got there. You know, the place was quiet, was organised, it was clean. And I think what blew me away the most was the carers.
Lots of girls were braiding each other's hair. There was, they were looking after the babies. Some of the babies were being, I think, washed at that point. Some of them were being washed, sleeping. I just wanted to see what in comparison to what I've got. Like, I take for granted that what I've got.
It's so tiny. As a nurse.
As a nurse? The most rewarding thing today for me was seeing that they were nurtured, their children were nurtured, they were cared, the seniors were looking after the juniors, there was lots of love, like, they were loved.
This is the big kitchen facility. This is where they prepare all the meals for all the kids twice a day. They get two meals a day. And all the food is donated by local grocers in the little village. And they bring it here every day. All fresh vegetables, no McDonald's here. The kids eat really well, really healthy. Let's take them all look through here. I would love to know what that is. I think this is the chocolate, the dessert. So I'm gonna stick my finger in. I'm gonna eat what they eat. I have no idea what that is. What is that? I don't know. I need to wipe it off. However, they love it. It's a bit probably like our Vegemite. It's a bit like that. So this is the first aid room. If they have a little bit of a scratch or a cold or a sore throat, ear infection, this is where they come and get some little supplies.
We didn't really give them much. We gave them lots of band-aids. Reflecting back, I wish we had got some, like, liquid Panadol for the the little ones and some more Panadol, because that's what they need mostly if they're sick, got temperature. Plenty of Band-Aids. What else? I would think more Panadol next time and block out. They would love to block out from the nursing perspective.
Upon the wind of heaven's love, past the planets and the stars, leave this lonely world of ours, escape the sorrow and the pain, and fly again.
The worst part was seeing like little babies that were like having trouble breathing, and but I just try to be all positive and
take your gentle happiness.
I saw some disabled people, you know, the kids and deformed kids, and I was thinking, you know, maybe affecting from the war, still the people are still suffering, the innocent kids.
Until we meet. Fly, fly, do not fear. Don't waste the breath, don't shed a tear. Your heart is pure, your soul is free.
Giving her the dolls, she screamed really loud and she was really excited, and you could see the smile on her face.
You want this one? So when we got there, we had the big birthday cake, the biggest cake I'd ever seen.
Oh, it was wonderful. Never seen a cake like it, but it was wonderful. We just wanted to celebrate today that these children don't get birthdays.
I believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess.
We had a birthday because none of the kids really have birthdays. They don't know when their birthday is.
Because they probably don't know when their birthday is.
Everybody's searching for a hero. People need some.
And we're going to cut the cake, and everybody can have a bit of cake. And then everybody is going to have a present for their birthday. Okay. So we all had a birthday, so it was technically, I said to them, it's all your birthday today, and we're just letting you know that you're all very important and you're the future of Vietnam. And
one of them asked me, a little girl, like, whose birthday are we celebrating? And I said, we're celebrating your birthday and celebrating everyone's birthday. She's like, oh, and then the monk came over and translated. She's like, oh.
There we go. Happy birthday. We'll probably fall down. You know how good I am at trying things.
I mean, you know, of course, their kids, they were blown away by all the material, you know, the toys and the, you know, the skipping ropes. I mean, the place was quiet. Not one child was playing when we got there. And then when we left, the little girls are skipping and the boys are doing the soccer through the little cones. And, oh, it was just so good.
This is part of the world that really still exists today. There's 120 children here at the orphanage. A lot of them have disabilities. A lot of them just simply parents couldn't afford to keep them. It's pretty much a reality check. However, the kids are really happy, and today giving them a birthday party just lets them know the importance of them being here on this earth and part of their Vietnamese community, and knowing that they've got a big future ahead of them. They all go to school, they all get taught to learn, and their futures are very bright. And it's such a great honour to be here. And this little boy's having his lunch. You like your hat? You like your hat?
Of all.
So we laid all the presents out on the table, all the necessities went that end, all the gifts went this end, and then by surprise, they all lined up. Boys lined up here, girls lined up here, and they all stepped forward one at a time, and they took what they were given. One little toy, and they appreciated it.
But now, I just gave this child a toothbrush, and the joy from the toothbrush was...
And that was at the orphanage today. We saw a lot of disabled kids. There was Down syndrome, there was a child who was blind, there was handicapped disabled kids. It's because the parents can't afford the medical for them. And they just thought being there, they're going to have a better opportunity. Very sad. And that always plays on my mind when I come here, always, that there's kids that just don't get the opportunity to be cared for.
I look into the window of my mind. Reflections of the fears I know I've left behind.
5 months old. His parents probably couldn't afford to keep him. They're busy working in the factories, earning money. The time, the money, unfortunately he can't stay with his parents. Maybe one day they'll come back and pick him up. But they get good care from the volunteers to look after them all. You just want to take him home.
Oh!
There you go. Look, toy on here. Oh, you poor little thing. A lot of them have disabilities and the parents obviously can't afford to get medical treatment for them. And this is the best option for them because they know they're going to get a better life. You're going to have a good life, aren't you, little boy? Yeah. Hello. Hello.
If I were Magellan, I would sail straight up to heaven and find you. It's true. If I were John Lennon, I would ask the world to imagine loving you. If I could, for you.
So if we could come back and do this every year, that would be wonderful.
Well, the best part was seeing them, how they were smiling. And then the worst part was like when we had to leave.
Things of the heart last a lot longer, you know, and this will last for us, with us forever.
Yeah.
You know, you can't put a figure on what you feel, you know.
The biggest memory was giving the little children the gifts, and the one little girl who got her little doll and was screaming through the orphanage with this doll.
We live in one world. It's only separated by waters and government. We all need to stick together and help where we can, and this is where I want to help. This is just something that I can do.
If another kid was to choose an envelope that had Disneyland and an orphanage, I would definitely tell them to go to the orphanage. It's like a great experience and I'll remember it for the rest of my life.
Because like now I've realised that they've got happy stuff now.
Thank you very much for giving Chanel this opportunity, and also thank you to Shona. She's a wonderful teacher. She does everything for Chanel. Go showcase.
And being there and giving the kids all these toys, however, they still went out of their way to make us feel welcome and special by coming into their home for the day. And it wasn't about us going there and giving presents to them. It was about them turning around and saying, you know, thank you for coming here just to visit us, just seeing people.
And when the stars come out across red velvet skies, I'll catch them all and take them home.
Seeing the kids that we've taken from Australia over here and seeing how they've come out of it. They haven't come out scarred, they've come out happy from it, and they're wanting to do more if they can. They'll probably appreciate more in life. And that's really good. I'm happy about that.
Can't stop me now, and you can do the same, yeah.